Chers vétérans de la Seconde Guerre mondiale, Votre Altesse royale, Premier ministre Attal, Président Michel du Conseil européen, mes chers amis, c'est un grand honneur pour moi d'être ici avec vous aujourd'hui pour souligner le 80e anniversaire du jour J et de la bataille de Normandie. 80 years ago, more than 14,000 Canadians landed at Juno Beach among the roughly 150,000 Allied forces who came ashore in Normandy. These soldiers had friends and family. They had lives and jobs before the war started. On the battlefields, Francophones, Anglophones, Indigenous peoples, and new Canadians came together as one. Brave Canadians like you sacrificed everything for our freedom. There are no words to describe the immensity of the debt we owe you. Il y a cinq ans, lors du 75e, et au cours des années, j'ai eu la chance de rencontrer nombreux d'entre vous. Chaque fois, je suis touché par votre candeur et votre humilité, sachant que vous avez tellement donné à votre pays. Vous avez sauvé le monde et nous vous en serons toujours reconnaissants. At age 99, Private William Seyfried, who's with us today, enjoys playing bridge with friends multiple times a week. Half of all the people he knows, so he of all people knows how fragile life is. So he's enjoying every second of it. He knows how fragile life is because while in combat, a grenade landed at his feet. He was only 21, and he said, not today. So he picked up the grenade and swiftly threw it back. Le sapeur Léopold Thibault, qui est aussi avec nous aujourd'hui, s'était enrôlé à Rimouski quand il avait un peu plus de 20 ans en 1941. Il a servi en Grande-Bretagne, en France, en Belgique et en Hollande, où il a travaillé sur les ponts Bailey, des ponts préfabriqués portatifs pour permettre aux Alliés d'avancer plus rapidement. Mais les efforts des soldats comme lui ont aussi créé des ponts entre le Canada et tous ces pays qui sont aujourd'hui parmi nos meilleurs amis et alliés. To win the war, the Allied High Command decided that the coast of Normandy would be the target of the amphibious assault on the continent. Canadian infantry and armored troops were assigned a landing zone of their own, right here at Juno Beach. It was a testament to the esteem held for Canadian soldiers that a country with such a relatively small population would be given such an important role in Operation Overlord. And Canadians proved up to the task. On this day, 80 years ago, Canadian troops progressed further inland than any of our allies. It was a remarkable achievement and a costly one, too. 359 Canadiens ont perdu la vie le jour du débarquement. Nous nous souviendrons d'eux. We shall remember them. We remember your sacrifice. We remember your stories. Il est de notre responsabilité à tous de continuer à partager ces histoires pour que les générations futures n'oublient pas l'héroïsme et le courage que cela a pris pour défendre nos libertés et se souvenir aussi des dangers et, des horreurs de la guerre. Honorary Lieutenant General Richard Romer, who turned 100 this year, and who is also with us today, is one of Canada's most decorated veterans. Over the decades, he's participated in and organized many commemoration events. In his words, The costly D-Day success at Juno Beach laid the unforeseeable foundation for the betterment of mankind. It is important for him that we never forget. So to General Romer, to Sergeant Armitage, who couldn't be here with us today, to able seaman Bill Cameron, who sadly passed away just last weekend. When I spoke with her a few days ago, his daughter Donna told me just how much he'd been looking forward to being here with all of you. His bags has been packed for weeks, and he was so proud to be coming back to Normandy. So for him, and for all the veterans, I can promise you that Canada and the world will keep commemorating this significant day for decades and generations to come. En plus de se remémorer vos histoires, il est de notre devoir à tous de rappeler aux générations de demain les principes pour lesquels vous vous êtes battus. La liberté, la démocratie, la justice. Our way of life didn't happen by accident, and it won't continue without effort. Democracy is still under threat today. It is threatened by aggressors who want to redraw borders. It is threatened by demagoguery, misinformation, disinformation, foreign interference. We must all continue to stand for democracy day in and day out. We owe it to future generations, and we owe it to the great women and men in uniform who sacrificed so much for our collective freedom, lest we forget. Merci.